Hey guys, I'm finally back with another video. I'm really sorry it took me so long. The holidays really consumed my life. I hope you guys had a great holiday and a happy new year. So this is my very first question and answer video. I got a lot of great questions. I printed them all out because I'm OCD like that. And I'm gonna try and do as many as possible, and please keep emailing me, leaving me comments, and I'll try to answer your questions as quickly and as thoroughly as possible. Before I get started, I do want to remind you that I'm not a professional hairstylist. I'm not a professional optician. These are just my personal opinions, and I'm answering questions based on my own experience. I've had locks for almost 6 years now. It'll be 6 years in February. So most of the things I've learned have been through trial and error. And just keep in mind that what works for me might not work for you, and vice versa. So if I give some advice that maybe you don't agree with, or you have a different take on it, please by all means share it with me and the viewers, because I just want this to be a forum where everyone can help each other and learn. The number one question that I always get is, how many locks do I have? The last time I counted, I had 114, and that did include my combined locks. But keep in mind, everybody's head is different, everyone's hair is different. So I get questions from people that say, how many locks should I get? Is this the right amount? Is this too small? And you know, you can't go into it saying, I want my hair to look exactly like that person, because it's not gonna happen. Everyone is different, everyone's experience is unique. So you need to just embrace the process and, you know, kind of see where it leads you. This is a question from Cherie1982. She says, I'm very tempted to bleach my hair because she really likes the red look, and she only wants to do a few similar to mine, but she's very scared. So give her my honest opinion. All right, my honest opinion is, do not dye your own hair. I know that I've done it. I went kind of crazy when I was in college doing lots of colors, but I actually did end up damaging my locks. Thankfully, I only did a few pieces here and there, but as you can see, for example, this one's really short. It used to be longer, and it actually broke off. The thing is, when you bleach your locks, sometimes the dye actually stays inside your locks. Because locks are so thick, it's really hard to get all of the dye out. So while initially you might think, oh, this is great, my hair looks amazing, there's still dye inside there that's really hard to wash out. So the best advice I can give anyone that's interested in dyeing their hair is to go to a professional. The last thing you want to do is to fry your hair and have all of it fall out. I have lost the ends of a few of my locks, thankfully. Not the entire lock, but as you can see, this one is like really thin. And honestly, it's not that big of a deal, but if I had dyed more of my locks or done it when my hair was a little older, I think that I might be a little more upset and lose more hair, and nobody wants that. Here's a good question from Lucienne. I think I'm totally messing up your name. I'm really sorry. So what are my thoughts on running a blow dryer over my hair after I twist it? Is that okay, or will it damage your hair? Any idea? Well, when you apply heat to your hair, you do run the risk of damaging your hair. But it's not going to make your hair fall out as long as you aren't using heat on it every single day, the same way you might when you use a blow dryer every single time you wash your hair, or a curling iron or a flat iron. I would suggest limiting how often you use a blow dryer, but in the long run, it's not gonna really hurt you. My suggestion would be after you get out of the shower, towel dry your hair. Your hair should not be sopping wet after you twist your hair. You really wanna towel dry it so it's damp, and that will kind of cut down on you even needing to use a blow dryer. Give it overnight, you'll be fine. Funny Kids Are Cool asks, how often should you twist? And I did kind of talk about it a little bit in my last video, but I get this question a lot. I try to twist every 2 to 3 weeks. It really just depends on how lazy I get. You always want to make sure that you twist your hair when it's wet. So what I do is every 2 weeks, I wash my hair and then I twist. You're free to like wash in between if you want. I personally don't do that because I don't like my twist to come out, and I don't want to twist too frequently. If you twist too much, you do run the risk of your locks getting thinner, and that's something that we don't want. Light of Beauty asks, when did retwisting your hair get easier? I'm at the 1 year mark. I retwist once every 2 months, And I guess my locks are still in the teenage stage because they don't seem to stay put after a retwist. Okay, well, there's a few questions in there. I think that retwisting my hair got easier maybe after I had been doing it for about a year, but I also twist more frequently than you do. So once every 2 months, like I said, it's personal preference, that might work for you, but it is gonna take longer for your hair to become trained and more accustomed to being twisted. So I twist every 2 to 3 weeks, and over time it did get easier, especially after I started using the method that I showed in my last video. It got a lot faster and a lot easier as a result. So hang in there, it does take some time, and there's nothing wrong with going to a professional stylist or getting someone else to do your hair for you if you find that it's still presenting a problem. Also, using product really helps as well. It's been about 2 weeks, and I don't know if you can see my roots, but my hair is still very well twisted since I twisted it in that video. So it does take time. It's all about training your locks and being consistent with how often you twist, making sure you twist in the same direction, twisting your hair when it's wet, and all of those things combined are going to make the process a lot easier, and also just hanging in there time-wise. Okay, let's do one more on this lift. You know, I got this question and I don't remember who it was from, I apologize, but someone asked me about my thoughts on latch hooking versus twisting. Like I said a million times now, it's really about personal preference. I latch hooked my hair when I first started and I didn't like how it looked on my hair. I thought that it started to make my locks thinner and I was really nervous about my hair getting too thin. And it also kind of changed the consistency of my lock, whereas they're very round, it kind of made them more flat and squarish, and I didn't really like that. So if latch hooking is something that you're interested in, I don't knock it, but you do want to pick one method and stick with it so that your locks are consistent. Because if you start one method and then you switch to another and then you go back, you might notice some inconsistencies in the shape and thickness of your locks. So like I said before, it's really up to you. Okay, I think that's enough questions for this time around. I'm going to try and be better about doing videos. That's one of my many resolutions for this year. So please leave me more of your questions or you can send me an email. I will put my email address in the description box. All right, thanks.